Welcome back, my dear students, to the offline video series of biology of class 6. Today we are going to start with the new lesson, and the name of the lesson is respiratory system. Each and every cell of plant, human being and animal body requires energy for day-to-day activities. For example, muscle cells contracts and relax for the movement of the body. Root cells penetrates into the soil to absorb minerals and nutrients. Brain cells receives and sends messages to the different parts of the body. In order to perform day-to-day activities in our daily life, we need energy. And this energy we get through the process of respiration. Respiration is the process in which the breakdown of glucose and food is done. That means the food which is converted into glucose through the process of digestion is used as energy in the process of respiration. The breakdown of glucose occurs by utilizing the oxygen which we take in through the air. Depending on the utilization of oxygen, there are two types of respirations: aerobic respiration, which consists of oxygen in it. That means in this type of respiration, oxygen is utilized. And the second type of respiration is anaerobic respiration. In this type of respiration, no oxygen is utilized. Now we are going to study about the different parts of respiratory system, that are nose, pharynx, larynx, trachea, etc. So, with the help of diagram, we are going to study about each part. This is how the respiratory system looks like, and these are the organs which are involved in respiratory system. The organs which are involved in respiratory system are nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, lungs, bronchi, alveoli, diaphragm, etc. So the first organ which we are going to study is nose. Nose is the point of the entry for the air. It has two openings, and these openings are called as nostrils. Each nostril leads to a nasal chamber. The nostrils has a hairy lining to prevent the dust particles from reaching into the lungs. This lining of nasal chamber has a sticky fluid called as mucus inside it. The nasal chamber warms and moistens the air which enters into the lungs. The inner lining of nose also has some special cells which can be used for smelling. The next organ is pharynx. As you can see in this diagram, pharynx is present above the larynx. The air passes behind the mouth into this pharynx or throat, which is a common passage for air and food both. It leads into the two passages, one for the air tube, which is also called as windpipe or trachea, and the other one for the food, which is also called as food pipe or esophagus. The next organ which is involved in respiration is larynx. As you can see in this diagram, that larynx is present exactly below the pharynx. At the entrance of the trachea, there is a voice box, and this voice box is nothing but the larynx itself. It contains two ligament folds, which are also called as vocal cords. The air which is expelled out through these vocal cords vibrates and produces the sound. The front opening of windpipe is called as glottis, and it has a muscular flap which is called as epiglottis. These epiglottis closes the windpipe at the time of swallowing of food.
incomplete closure of these epiglottis may lead to coughing. These are the positions of organs which we studied now, such as pharynx, larynx, glottis and epiglottis. Here are two figures, figure A, which shows you both passages, the passage into the windpipe and into the food pipe. Figure B shows you the opening into the windpipe and closed food enter into the food pipe.